Horizontal scrolling has been around for quite a while and can be often seen on personal portfolio and resume websites. So in this tutorial, we will show you how to create it with pure CSS using transform technique in just a few minutes. Let's check it out. The concept of this tutorial is to use double CSS transform. First, we will create content blocks and put them under two layers of wrappers. Then we will rotate the outer wrapper so the top side is on the left and the bottom is on the right. This way we turn vertical scroll into horizontal one. Then we rotate the inner wrapper back so the content is in the right position. Now let's start with the HTML structure. Create double layers of wrappers and the content. It's not necessary to create multiple content divs like this. You can create a single long content element if you like. For CSS, first I'm going to set width and height of each content div or slide to 100% of viewport. Again, it's not necessary for slide width to be equal. Then set the layout of the inner wrapper to flex with flex direction as row. This will put all the slides next to each other on a single line. Also set the width to 400% of the viewport. We need to make sure that the value is equal to total width of the content divs, and then set different colors for each slide. Now all divs are in place, but we cannot use mouse wheel to scroll through yet. Let's work on the outer wrapper. I will set the outer wrapper size to 100% of the viewport. Because we will need to rotate this wrapper, the trick is to set the width to 100% of the viewport height and height to 100% of the viewport width. Then use transform to rotate it by 90 degrees and set transform origin to top left. Then we will disable the x-axis scroll and enable y. Finally, we will apply the opposite rotation to the inner wrapper. Now we can't see anything. This is because the wrapper's position were changed due to the rotation, so we need to move them back. We will just add translate x and y to the transform. Also set the outer wrapper position to absolute. Now we can use the mouse wheel to scroll horizontally, but the scroll bar is taking up the content space and it doesn't look nice, so we will hide it. Unfortunately, there is no direct CSS property to hide the scroll bar, so we will need to apply different methods for each browser. For Firefox, we can set scroll bar width to none. For IE family, we can use MS prefix, MS overflow style. For Chrome and Safari, we will need to use WebKit scroll bar selector and set the display to none. With this technique, we can create an interactive website by simply load a seamless background image. So that's all for this tutorial, hope you guys enjoy. If you want to see more development tips and tutorials, subscribe to our channel for weekly videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!